my next question is twofold. Given the demand for automobiles has been so volatile in domestic and international markets, how do you anticipate demand going forward, and firstly in the international market and secondly in the domestic market from here?
Well, I think India has certain, and we are seeing the numbers coming from all the car makers and all that, though there is a remarkable improvement there. But still, it's not sort of the great feeling that one had about 2 or 3 years ago. I believe that this particular thing will improve. The environment will improve, and hence the car demand in India will also go up. But please remember that Motherson is not just dependent upon the car's numbers to go up, because we are also improving the content per car. So while the numbers may be flattish or a small gain is there, we are also increasing the content per car. So when we increase the content per car, there is a definite growth that comes up in our top line. And that's what I was saying, that even in a quarter like the last quarter, the Indian standalone sales are up by 14%. It's also important to understand that with the rupee weakening where it is, your exports become that much more plausible and affordable for the customers also. So we believe that that opens up even more avenues for Motherson in the future. The key point for Motherson is that we are 100% dependent upon the OEMs. So we have to find ways and means by which we can augment our resources on the top line. So that's what we keep doing, and that's what we keep focusing on.
Sure. In fact, so Europe's macroeconomic variables have shown some signs of improvement of late. Given you have a significant exposure to that market, what's your outlook in terms of business?
I think definitely it was very heartening to see yesterday that Spain has come out from recession. We believe that recession does have an effect on the automotive industry. But by and large, when we breathe with the market, we don't have this. We shouldn't be really worried about it. Secondly, the demand is going up. Also, we must consider that Europe makes some of the best cars in the world, and the demand for that particular thing is all across the globe. So even at a euro-dollar parity of 1.38, the numbers of the car makers are doing better and better.
Sir, also a word on the impact of currency volatility on your financial statement for the quarter?
Well, I think the group is so diversified, and we have a simple policy of 3CX15, which means no country, no component, and no car maker more than 15% of our turnover. We do have a very de-risked kind of a model. So we buy and sell in the same currencies, and hence we are not really affected other than just translation losses. In fact, the whole of the 6 months that have gone by, the first half, all the new plants that we have set up, the investments that we are making in capexes and all these things are all coming from internal accruals and are locally been taken care of in the plants in the countries where they are. So I think it's just about management of these particular things and not allowing it to affect the company's performance.